Hayes swooping in, plays it on top. Gostis bears quick trigger. Covered up by Samsonov, who was paddled down to make that stop. Oshie clearing it ahead as the horn sounds. So that's the end of the second period now, officially in Philadelphia, with Washington leading 4-1. Chara needs to be kept away. We'll give you an idea just how tall the linesman Ryan Daisy is. He's almost eye-to-eye with Z, who's 7 foot tall on skates.
He said he was hit in the head there, and he's a none-too-pleased big guy. There he is along the wall working the puck. You'll see the puck come in front of the net. There's the hacking and whacking, Konecny and Jensen. And then Lawton's stick comes up a little high right there, just on the left side of the net. And that's what made Chara very mad. You don't want to wake him up, Joe. And a little slash across the legs of Konecny, trying to get retribution. And he's very, I haven't seen him this upset since he's become a cap.
During our intermission lull, we thank NBC Sports Philadelphia's Keith Jones for conducting an interview with John Carlson. And you got the sense, Locker, during that interview that John was hoping that his mates would keep the pedal down. Now they've lost some 3-goal leads this season that have not set well with them.
Yep, and there's Chara with Konecny and Lawton. Yeah, I mean, case in point, last game they made mistake after mistake. You know, even Laviolette said it was a line change, it was a miscue, it was poor puck management. And to start the third period, we'll have some coincidental minor penalties.
A real marquee matchup presented by Sandy Spring Bank. Real banking for real life and real business. John Carlson checking out the scoreboard.